Hey, did you read the paper for Journal Club this week?
Yeah, it was kind of a tough read.
Yeah, there's a lot of jargon in it. Yeah, it's kind of difficult.
Yeah, pretty tough to get through.
All right, guys, thanks for coming to Journal Club this week. We're going to do birthday songs. This is by Chains et al. From the West Lab, and they are at Def Jam, which I think is a university.
They ask me what I do and who I do it for, and how I come up with this shit up in the studio. All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe. All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe.
Okay, weird. I've never heard of Plus Zero before, though.
All right, so let's just go ahead and get straight into the data. It says here in figure one, when I die, bury me in the Gucci store. When I die, bury me inside the Louis store.
When I die, bury me inside the Gucci style. When I die, bury me inside the Louis style.
You know, that doesn't really make any sense to me. What do you think?
Yeah, actually, that's a really good point. It's really not specific. I mean, does he want to be cut in half and buried half at each location?
If we preach it, then we practice. Don't be reaching, don't be touching shit. We and Kanye West be.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, but another thing that I wonder about, does everyone agree with the nomenclature brought up in this, in this first paragraph?
Wrist moving, cook, getting to it.
She's got a big booty, so I call her big booty.
She got a big booty, so I call her big booty.
Is that like a standard thing in the field?
Yeah, that's pretty reasonable. The authors assert here that, quote, I don't have more bombs than Pakistan. Do you guys see any evidence for this movie?
Yeah, actually, if you look at table one, though, the data seems pretty suspect. I don't think they have anything to support this conclusion.
I come up with this shit up in the studio.
All right. Let's just go on to figure two. I think here they're addressing the claims that the authors are, quote, in the kitchen, yams everywhere.
I'm in the kitchen, yams everywhere.
I think they make a pretty solid case for this.
Seems
like their data is pretty well supported there.
All right.
So what do you think about the general conclusions about the paper?
Well, I mean, their model slide in figure four, I just think that's not really supported by the data. You know, Deuce and Ye clearly have not established themselves as Snoop and Dre, as the paper states.
Deuce and Ye, we like Snoop and Dre.
I mean, do we really even think that they've answered the main questions that they brought up in the introduction?
I've got to say no. I mean, the two main questions they lay out in the introduction of the paper are...
They ask me what I do and who I do it for.
What do you do and who do you do it for?
And how I come up with this shit up in the studio.
And then, how do you come up with this shit inside the studio?
All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe. All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe.
And I don't really think that all I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe really even addresses that at all.
Yeah.
Well, that's a great
one. All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe. All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe. Yeezy, how you doing, huh? It's my birthday, I deserve to be greedy, huh? She holding out, she ain't giving to the needy, huh? You go downstairs and fall asleep with the TV on. Y'all been together 10 years, you deserve a menage. Especially if you put that BMW in a garage. Especially if you paid a couple payments on her mama crib. Went to her niece's graduate.